This is Suma Jan Bhaskar. In this session, we are going to see a wonderful story. A Tale of Two Bullocks, written by Munshi Premchand. Unit 2, Animal Tales, Prose 1. Book page number 28 to 32. Let us know about the author. Who has written this story? We know Munshi Premchand. What is his real name? His real name is Danbat Roy Srivatsava. And he was an Indian writer famous for his modern literature. He is one of the most celebrated writers of the Indian subcontinent and is regarded as one of the foremost Hindi writers of the early 20th century. And he has written many novels, and his works include more than a dozen novels, around 300 short stories and several essays. And he has translated many books from foreign literature to Hindi language. Now we are going to learn new words from this lesson. Yeah, just we have taken these words from this lesson. Here, the character Hira and Moti, two bullocks. And Hira means diamond and Moti means pearl. And stature, size. Hostility and friendly feeling or behavior. Pummel, hit. Yoke, animal harness. Fatigue, extreme tiredness. Trough, container for giving food or water to animals. Tyrant, someone who treats people they have power or in a cruel way. Then next word, mute, silent. Tether, rope to tie up animals. Loafers, lazy people. Slandered, made a false statement about someone that could damage their reputation. Aggravated, annoyed. Insipid, tasteless. Savior, taste. Caution, wand. Communion, state of sharing or exchanging thoughts and feelings. Gnaw, chew. Conferring, discussing. Scarcely, hardly. Embankment, a wall of stone or earth made to keep water back. Comrade, here in this lesson meaning friend. Haunches, area of the body which includes the bottom, the hips and the tops of the legs. Budge, move. Auction, sale where items are sold to those who offer the highest price. Strutting, walking in a proud way. Now, just we'll see the characters in this story. Jury, the vegetable farmer, two bullocks, Hira and Moti, Jury's wife, and Gaya, Jury's brother-in-law, the buyer, and Baru's daughter, a young girl. Now we are going to see about the two bullocks, the hero of this story. Hira and Moti. We know meaning for this diamond and pearl. Both were a fine purchaser of great stature, means size, beautiful and hardworking. They lived together for a very long time and become sworn brothers. They would speak to each other in their silent language and would express their love by licking and sniffing one another. Here, actually, these two bullocks were there with Jury for a long time. So they were a good friend and they became like a real brothers, that means own brothers. And they are hard working bullocks. And they just speak to each other in their silent language, mute language, to express their love. How you could be seen how animals shows their loves, okay, by licking and sniffing one another. Sometimes they would even lock horns, not from hostility but rather out of friendship and a sense of fun, the way close friends slap and pummel one another. When they were released from the yoke after their day's work, at noon or in the evening, they would lick and nuzzle one another to ease their fatigue, means tiredness. When the oilseed cake and straw was tossed into the manger, they would stand up, thrust their muscles into the trough together and sit down side by side to eat. Now, Hira and Moti, these two bullocks, they were very close friends and just they will hit and play like how the close friends play. The same way they will also do. And once they have completed their work in the noon or evening, just they'll come home and they would lick and nuzzle one another to ease their tiredness. And the master of this bullock will give oil seed cake and straw, and they will eat together and sit side by side and eat these things. Jury sent the pair to his father-in-law's. The bullocks assumed that the master had sold them. They wanted to ask Jury, "Why are you throwing us out? We have done everything possible to serve you well. We ate whatever you gave us without complaint. If you had to, you could have made us work harder. Why did you sell us to this tyrant?" One day, Jury, the bullock's master, sent them to his father-in-law's house. This bullocks thought that the master sold them to the new master, and they wanted to ask Jury, "Why are you throwing us out? And whatever you want we have done, and whatever you have given to us, just without complaint we ate. And if you want, you could have given more work to us. Why did you sell us to this cruel person?" The two bullocks reached their new house in the evening, hungry after a whole day without food, but neither so much as stuck in his mouth in the trough of food. Their hearts were heavy. They glanced at one another, deciding something in their mute language, and lay down. At night, they pulled hard, broke their tether, and set out from home. The person who came to took this bullocks, he took the bullocks to his house, new house, and the whole day they walked and went, no food for them, they were hungry. And after reaching the house, they felt very bad and they just looked at each other and they decided in their mute silent language. And at night, in the house everyone slept, these two decided and just broke their tether. Tether means the rope, and set out from there, from home. Okay, they escaped from that house. When Jury got up early in the morning, he saw his two bullocks standing at the trough, half a tether dangling from each of their necks. Instead of being angry, he was overwhelmed with affection for them. He ran and threw his arms around their necks, and very pleasant was the spectacle of the loving embrace. What happened? The next day morning, they reached Jury's home, that means old master's house. When Jury came out in the morning, he saw those two bullocks were standing in their place, and in their neck the tether, the rope, was dangling. And what he has to do? He didn't get angry, and instead of that he was very happy. He ran to them and just put his arms around their necks and showed his love. Then Jury's wife caught sight of them. She said angrily, "These loafers of oxen." They ran away without even working for a day at my father's. Here he was happy, but Jury's wife got angry because Jury's brother only came and took these two bullocks to her father's house. But these two, they didn't work for them, simply they came back the next day itself. So she got angry and she used the word loafer. Loafer means lazy people. Yes, just she compared with lazy people. Jury could not listen to his bullocks being slandered like this. Loafers are they? I am sure they were not fed properly, or they wouldn't have run off. Aggravated, she said, "They ran away because those people won't spoil them, unlike you. These bullocks are real lazy bones. I'll give them nothing but dry straw now." At mealtime, when the bullocks put their faces in their trough, they found it insipid. Insipid means tasteless. No savior, no juice. How could they eat it? They began to stare toward the door. What happened? Now Jury's wife got angry. Then she said she's not going to give any food for them except dry straw at the mealtime. Okay. These two bullocks waiting for oilseed cake, straw and other things how their master Jury gives. But now they didn't get good food, so they were just looking at the door. Said to the hired hand in charge of feeding them, "Why don't you throw in a little oil seed?" "Oh no, the mistress will surely fire me then." The next day, Jury's brother-in-law, Gaya, came again and took the bullocks. This time, he yoked them to his wagon. Moti wanted to knock the wagon into the ditch, but Hira, who was more tolerant, held him back. When they reached the house, Gaya tied them with thick ropes and threw down the same dry straw. The two bullocks had never suffered such an insult. They didn't even bother to look in the trough. Hear what happened. Now, Jury's wife ordered the person to not give good food to them. So they were looking at the doorstep. And now, when Jury came out, he saw the trough of this buffalo bullocks, but except dry straw, nothing was there. So she asked the helper to give some oil seed cake. Then he was not ready to give. He just replied, "If I give, definitely mistress, that means Jury's wife, will surely fire him." And next day again Gaya came and took these two bullocks. Last time they went by walk. This time what he did, he tied them in the wagon. And they have to take that wagon means carriage. And now Moti got angry. He was trying to hit the wagon. And Hira was silent and he was more tolerant. So he stopped Moti to do this action. Then when they reached house, Gaya this time used thicker rope to tie them, because last time they escaped because the rope was very thin, so they could cut and just escape from the place. This time he used thick ropes for tying them. And now he just offered only dry straw, the same food what he offered. And now they felt, because Jury never gave them like this food, because they got good food, good time in Jury's home. So they didn't want to eat that. Simply they were standing. Day, Gaya yoked them to the club, but it was as tough the two of them had sworn not to lift their foot. Gaya grew tired beating them. Once, when the cruel man delivered a sharp blow on Hira's nostrils, Moti took to his heels with a bluff in anger. Bluff, shear, rope, yoke, harness, all were smashed to pieces. But for the strong ropes around their necks, the bullocks would have escaped. The next day, Gaya took them to their field to work, but these two bullocks decided not to work. So Gaya started beating them, but Gaya became tired beating them. So what he did, he took another action that just the cruel man, Gaya, delivered a sharp blow on Hira's nostril. Okay, she was quite right. But Moti got angry, just he shown his opposition and he just broken everything. But the thick rope, he tied, Gaya tied them in thick rope, right? If it is not there, the thick rope is not there, then they could have escaped from that place. When Juri got up early in the morning, he saw his two bullocks standing at the trough, half a tether dangling from each of their necks. Instead of being angry, he was overwhelmed with affection for them. He ran and threw his arms around their necks, and very pleasant was the spectacle of the loving embrace. What happened? The next day morning, they reached Juri's home, that means old master's house. When Juri came out in the morning, he saw those two bullocks were standing in their place. And in their neck, the tether, the rope was dangling. And what he has to do? He didn't get angry. And instead of that, he was very happy. He ran to them and he just put his arms around their necks and showed his love. When they saw his fierce look, Gaya and his helpers decided to put off the beating, for if he had not, Moti would have struck back. At their stall, the dry straw was brought to them. They stood in silence. The people were eating dinner in the house. Now, those two bullocks, Hira and Moti, just show their fierce look, and Gaya and his helpers decided not to beat them. If again they are beating, definitely the last time, what is the incident happened? They broke all the instruments, like the same way now it will happen. So Gaya and the helpers decided not to beat this bullocks. Then they have brought to their stall. There they offered only dry straw, but they didn't eat that. They were standing simply. But Gaya's home, they were eating their dinner. Now, a young girl came out carrying two pieces of bread. She fed them. How could a piece of bread still their hunger? But in their hearts, they felt as though they had been fed a full meal. The girl was Baro's daughter. Her mother was dead and her stepmother bit her often. So she felt sorry for the bullocks. Gaya's family, they were taking their dinner. And now, there was a young girl, just she came out and she brought 2 pieces of bread, and those breads given to Hiran Moti. These 2 pieces will not fill their hunger, but still, those 2 bullocks felt happy and they felt they ate fully. Who is that girl? The girl was Baro's daughter. That means Gaya's sister, Juri's wife's sister. Actually, Baro's daughter, a young girl, her mother was dead and stepmother just often bit her, and she knows this situation. People are not there to take care of them. What would be the situation? She knows that. So she understood this bullock's situation and fed them. Bullocks ate those 2 pieces of bread and they were. So the days took to a pattern. The 2 were yoked all day, took a lot of beatings, and in the evening were tied up in their shed. At night, the girl would feed them some bread. Thanks to this communion of love, though they ate only a few mouthfuls of the dry straw, they did not grow weak. One day, Moti said, "I can't stand it any longer. Tonight, we will break the ropes and run away." At night, after the girl left, the 2 began to gnaw at their ropes, but the thick cord wouldn't even fit in their mouths. Suddenly, the door of the house opened and the girl came out. The bullocks began to lick her hand. Their tails stood up while she stroked their foreheads. Here, at Gaya's house, these 2 bullocks did not treated properly. Just they got beatings and worked hard, but still, they got only dry straw. People did not feed them properly, except that young girl, Baro's daughter. Just every day, she came and fed them breads. Okay, they got good friendship at Gaya's house. And one day, Moti decided to escape from that house. So, one day, night, they started chewing their ropes. It was thicker, right? So, it was not fit in their mouths. Suddenly, the door of the house opened. The young girl, that small girl came out. The young girl came out. And after seeing that, the bullocks began to lick her hand. And she was just stroking their foreheads. "I'm going to let you go," she said. "Be very quiet and run away, or these people will kill you." She untied the rope, but the 2 stood silently, conferring. "Well, let's go," Hira decided. "Though this girl is going to be in a lot of trouble tomorrow." Perhaps to force the bullocks to escape, the girl suddenly yelled, "Father, come quick. Uncle's bullocks are running away." Then Gaya came rushing out of the house. The bullocks began running with him fast behind them. Gaya soon turned back to feed some villagers. The 2 friends kept running straight ahead. Here what happens? They decided, Hira and Moti decided to escape from the house again. And they were chewing their rope. Okay, tethers. And it was thicker. They couldn't cut it. But that time, the door was open, the house door opened. That young girl came out, and now just she untied the rope of the bullocks and she said, "Just move from this place, otherwise these people will kill you." Okay, now these 2 bullocks didn't move from that place. They stood silently and discussing something. Now Hira decided, "Okay, let's go. But anyway, this girl is going to be in trouble, because if people came to know she only just untied the rope, then she will be in trouble. Okay, but they were thinking that, but this girl wanted to just save this bullocks. So suddenly started shouting like, "Father, these bullocks are running from this place." Then immediately Gaya came out. Okay, Gaya came out and he was just going to catch the bullocks, but unable to catch them. Then Gaya just returned back to the village and fetched some villagers. By the time, these two friends just kept running straight ahead. Just they were running somewhere. Now we are going to learn new words from this lesson. One day, someone beat a drum outside the enclosure. A crowd gathered. The two friends were brought out and inspected. There came a man who dug his fingers into haunches of the bullocks and began to talk with the clerk. Soon, the bullocks were sold and the friends went off with the man. They were trembling and could scarcely lift their feet, but they stumbled along for their fear of being beaten. After some time, the road suddenly seemed familiar. Yes, this was the road by which Gaya had taken them away. Their pace quickened. Their weariness disappeared. Here was their own meadow, the well where they had walked the pulley. The next day, okay, they were standing in the edge of the field, right? The next day they could hear drums sound and crowd gathered in that place. And someone came and inspected them, and one man came and just fixed the price, spoke to the clerk and took the bullocks. The clerks from clerk. Okay, now they didn't eat food for a week. How they'll be? They were very weak and they were trembling, shivering. They couldn't even walk. Okay, but if they are not walking, definitely the person will beat with that fear. Because of that, just they walk with that man. Suddenly, the road was very familiar for these bullocks. Okay, And yes, that was the road where Gaya took them to his house. Now they got little bit energy and just their tiredness, everything disappeared. And they could see where they worked, the old place. They reached their old working place. Moti said, "Our house is close by. I'm making a run for home," said Hira. "We will make it to our stalls and won't budge from there. If the man tries to stop us, I'll knock him down." Joyfully kicking up their heels like calves, the friends made up for their house. They hurtled in and stood by their stall while the man came dashing after them. Jure was sitting in his doorway sunning himself. Surprised as he was, he ran up and embraced them. Tears of joy flowed from the two friends' eyes, and one of them licked Jure's hand. Meanwhile, the buyer came huffing up and grabbed their tethers. "These are my bullocks," said Jure. "Here what happens when the person just got these bullocks from the clerk, just he paid and took these two bullocks. Okay, now they could just see their house, that means Jure's house. So they started going to their place. So they ran and stood in their stall. Okay, they decided if the buyer came and took us, then definitely I'm going to kick him. And just they were full of happy because they came to their master's house. Okay, they got energy now. Just they were going like a calves, just jumping like a calves and going to their house. Their Jure was sitting in the doorway and sunning himself. And he got surprised, and these two bullocks also were so happy because they came to their favorite master, lovable master, Jure. Meanwhile, the buyer came and took the tethers, ropes, just grabbed the ropes. Okay, now Jure said, "These are my bullocks," because this is Jure's bullocks only, right? So Jure said, "This is my bullocks," because Jure doesn't know that the person just got it from the clerk. Just he has paid for this bullocks. So Jure said, "These are my bullocks. How can they be? I just bought them at an auction. I'll bet you stole them," said Jure. "I'll go to the police station and make a complaint. You do what you want. They are my bullocks. The proof is they came and stood at my door." In a rage, the man stepped forward to drag the bullocks away. Moti lowered his hands and charged. Here what happens? The argument happened because Jure doesn't know the person just paid and took these bullocks. At the same way, the person doesn't know this is Jure's bullock. Okay, now they were arguing and finally the buyer said, "I'm going to police station and lodge a complaint." Okay, Jure replied, "Just you go and do whatever you want. But these are my bullocks. The proof is that they came to my house. They are standing in my house." Okay. Now the person just went to just drag the bullocks away from Jure. But Moti, what he did? Just lowered his hands and charged. Jure sent the pair to his father-in-law's. The bullocks assumed that the master had sold them. They wanted to ask Jure, "Why are you throwing us out? We have done everything possible to serve you well. We ate whatever you gave us without complaint. If you had to, you could have made us work harder. Why did you sell us to this tyrant?" One day, Jure, the bullock's master, sent them to his father-in-law's house. These bullocks thought that the master sold them to the new master. And they wanted to ask jury, why are you throwing us out? And whatever you want, we have done. And whatever you have given to us, just without complaint, we ate. And if you want, you could have given more work to us. Why did you sell us to this cruel person? Then next word, mute, silent, tether, rope to tie up animals, loafers, lazy people, slandered, made a false statement about someone that could damage their reputation, aggravated, annoyed, insipid, tasteless, savior, taste, caution, wand. Now we are going to learn new words from this lesson.